Show you guys my skincare routine at night, and I'll probably do another version of this tomorrow morning. But I've been having some comments lately about, oh, your skin looks so nice. And truly and honestly, I think it's just you guys think I have good skin because you see, like, it looks oily, so that may make the appearance look like I have good skin. But, like, truly, look, like, I have been breaking out lately, and I don't know if you can see it, like, thing one and thing two appeared last night or sometime yesterday. So yeah, like, my skin is very oily and acne prone. So I actually do see a dermatologist. So some of the products that I use were, two products were recommended by a dermatologist. One you can just buy, like, online, like from Amazon or Dermstore. I've even seen it on lovelyskin.com. I'll leave a link below. But the other product is a prescription. It's a is Retin A. That's a prescription, so that's not something you can just buy over the counter, from my knowledge. But the other products weren't necessarily recommended, just things that I like and I use. So let's get into my nighttime skincare. So let me pull my hair back first. I probably need to put a clip on. So first, let me show you guys the skincare products I use. So I keep all my skincare in my medicine cabinet. Here, let me. So this, what you see here, that, like, this little area is pretty much my skincare, and that, and up here is a couple products I use too. Okay. So the first thing I use is a acne face wash. This is something that my dermatologist recommended that I use, and I've been using it for a few years, actually. Sometimes I get, she recommended the 5%, sometimes I get the 10%. It just depends. With that, y'all, I still use a Clarisonic. I know it's been discontinued, but this is, like, my favorite. I don't know if it's actually doing anything. I feel like it does. I feel like it's getting all the dead skin off, because I use Retin A, and Retin A, it does, like, the cell turnover faster. So your skin is always peeling. And I feel like this in the morning helps get all that dead skin off. Like, you may see it in the morning. We'll see. But I love the Clarisonic, and I actually bought, like, in 2020 when they went out of business, or when they announced they were going out of business, I bought so many brush head, like, replacement brush heads from them. I actually brought a second Clarisonic, like, a backup just in case. My first two Clarisonics lasted me, like, 5 years, and I was like, I'm gonna stock up on as many Clarisonic brush heads, and I'm gonna get a replacement brush just in case. You never know. And this is the one with the newer technology I used to have. Hold on. Okay, I'm back. Sorry about that. So, I forgot where I left off, but I think I was talking about the Clarisonic. This is my favorite brush. I bought several replacement brush heads when, before they, you know, completely were wiped out, cleaned out. Let me show you guys actually some. So this is my backup Clarisonic brush. And then this is, like, just some of the brushes. I have plenty more in my closet, but this is just a couple of them. But yes, love this product. I'm sorry. Like, I don't know why people don't like to show products that are discontinued, but I'm still going to be using my Clarisonic hopefully for years to come. And then when this one craps out, I have this one to use. I have so many replacement brush heads to use. So I hope they last me about the same amount of time. So I tried to like plan it out based on how often you're supposed to replace them. But I wash my face using these two products. So that, and then I'm going to just put on my skincare. So let's do that first. I'm gonna take a reusable cotton pad and I'm going, did I open this? Okay, so this isn't a part of my normal skincare routine, but I recently unboxed this glycolic acid with you guys from The Ordinary. So I'm gonna be trying this out today. So it says to put it on like a cotton pad and sweep it across your face. So let's try this out. I don't know if I'm doing this right. I probably should have read the back of that a little bit better. All right, so next, I like to go in with my, this is the Deacon, oh. This is called Raw Sauce. It's by Makeup. I buy this from a company called Peach and Lily. Sephora used to sell it like years ago, but they stopped selling it. So, and that's where I first discovered it, was at Sephora, but they don't sell it there anymore. So I buy it from Peach and Lily because they do. And it's kind of like an essence. You know how people like the SK-II facial treatment essence? And I actually just got a sample of that. I should use that. Maybe that's why I got these two little months, because I did try out the sample. Look, I'm not gonna blame it on that, but I did try out the sample that I got a couple of days ago. But I don't know. It smells like bubbles to me. Like, I don't know what. Here. This is the little sample I got with my Sephora order. Yeah, it smells like bubbles. You know, like when you're a kid and you get the bubbles and you blow, that's what this smells like. Like, I don't know how this is some kind of miracle thing. It's when it smells like just bubbles I can buy from the Dollar Tree. Like, we'll see. I don't know, y'all. Don't come for me if you love this product. I'm just telling you what it smells like to me in the sample. So, pat this on. But yeah, I put on my essence and serums and things first before I put on like my treatment. Like my acne creams and stuff. Okay. Yeah, it still smells like bubbles to me. Like, yeah, I wish I had some little kids' bubbles so y'all can smell it, but yeah. All right, so then next I'm gonna go in with the eye serum I use, which is this caffeine solution, also by The Ordinary. I like this product. This is actually a replacement I just bought as well, which you guys should have seen me unbox. All right, and then next, I'm gonna go in with, so I actually have two different like brightening serums that I use. Like this one is a dark spot corrector by Differin, and this is the vitamin C serum from Sunday Riley. I like this one because I can use this day and night, where this one is only, I believe, for night use, because it has, does it still have hydroquinone? At least it used to. So actually I will use this tonight, but I do prefer this. I'll probably use this in the morning. Don't forget your neck. It needs to match as much as possible. And then next I'm gonna go in with my acne cream. I use this benzoyl peroxide acne cream by Acne Free. I do use this to spot treat acne. And lately I've been having a lot of breakouts like around here, obviously here around my nose, so I'm just gonna spread any of the extra in those areas. All right, and then I'm gonna go in with my Belief moisturizing balm, or hold on, what is this, the moisturizing balm? Okay, so no, this one is the True Cream. There's a So there's the Aqua Balm. Okay, so it's Aqua Balm and Moisturizing Balm. The Aqua Balm I use in the summertime because it's lightweight, but in the wintertime I use the moisturizing balm. Like, they are different colors when you open them. So this is the Aqua Balm. You can see it's blue on the inside. And this is the moisturizing balm, which I use in the winter because it's thicker, it's white. So I like this for the winter time, especially for my skin with all the peeling and stuff that it does. This is like the one that helps the most with peeling, I notice, especially under makeup. So I purchase it all the time. Like, I even have, like, y'all, I love this product. I will continue to purchase it unless they, for some reason, decide to change the formula or discontinue it, which we hope they don't do. Oh, and I thought it's right here, like, look, y'all. I bought this from Sephora when they had their Sephora sale, so yes, love this. And I bought a backup of the Sunday Riley thing too. Y'all, I like what I like, and I'll buy backups of it if I like it. Okay, so let me actually go and put it on. But yeah, if you are on some kind of retinoid or Retin-A or something like that, and you need something to kind of help, you know, with your skin peeling, I really recommend this. It's not like a 100%, oh, you won't notice any peeling or flakiness in your skin, but for me, at least, it's what I found helps the most with it not being apparent during the day or being apparent under makeup. Okay, so last but not least is just the Retin-A. I put that on last. I know some people put on, so this is my Retin-A prescription. I know some people put on the Retin-A and then a moisturizer on top. I found that I like it with a moisturizer underneath more. That's my personal preference, but you're supposed to use a pea-sized amount on your entire face. And just rub it in. And that is it for my nighttime skincare routine, you guys. Oh, there's one more thing. Because my lips are dry. I use on my lips my favorite lip balm, which is Lana Lips. I have plenty of these backed up, but they're all, like, I have one in my purse, I have one at my desk, I have a backup under my sink somewhere. But yeah. Keeps my lips very moisturized at nighttime, and when I wake up, it feels that way too. So that is going to be it. So I will see you guys in the morning. Okay, good morning, everyone. It's Thursday today. I've already showered and everything, but I told you guys I'd show you my skincare routine in the morning. I'm just going to kind of, like, speed through all the stuff that's the same as nighttime skincare, because most of it is pretty much exactly the same products. I may switch out like one or two products, so I'll show you guys that. So okay, so I showed you guys this last night, but it's the Sunday Riley Vitamin C Serum. Hopefully showing. So I'm gonna use that this morning. And this I can kind of just use it on certain spots. I don't have to use it all over. Okay, so next I'm gonna go in with my acne cream again. I showed this last night, so we don't have to. And yes, I use it morning and night because acne, you know, I have acne for life. I have child acne, I had teenage acne, adult acne, you know, so I just have acne for life is what it seems like. All right, going in again with the Belief Moisture Balm, the True Cream. And I don't use as much as this Like, I use it, but I don't use as much in the morning time as I do at night, because I also use this Oil of Olay moisturizer that has a little bit of SPF, and then I will sometimes go over it with this other Olay SPF 30. So, yeah. I don't like the smell of SPF. I really don't. Like, it really discourages me from using it. I wish it would smell better. If you guys know of a product that smells better that has SPF in it, let me know. But it's good for the skin, whether you are going outside in the sun or not, or whether it's just like a cloudy, gloomy day like it is today. That is pretty much it for my night and morning skincare routine. I am gonna go back to bed because, today's my birthday, so happy birthday to me. But I took the day off for my birthday. I'll probably pick the camera back up a little later, but I'm tired. Like, I didn't sleep at all last night, so I need a nap. But I just wanted to get up and show you guys my morning routine, so it's actually in the morning. But yeah, your girl is tired. I need a nap, so I'll see you guys later on today. Okay, you guys, so I took my little nap. I put on a little bit of makeup. I'm about to head out. I'm gonna go to Starbucks first and get me a coffee, and then I need to go do some recycling. I need to go to the recycling center. Like, my recycling bins are full. So I'm gonna go to the recycling center, and I need to run some other errands and get something to eat, and then I'm coming back home. Y'all, we haven't seen the sun in Atlanta in like 2 weeks. Oh my gosh, it was raining this morning, but I can actually see the sun. Thank the Lord. Week since I last vlogged, and I think I vlogged last, it was my birthday, so I wanted to come on to close this like birthday vlog out. I need to wrap some Christmas presents, and I bought myself some things for my birthday and for Christmas, so I want to, like, do y'all do this? Do y'all wrap your Christmas gifts even though you bought yourself, like, it's from me to me, but I'm still gonna wrap it and put it under the Christmas tree. I've been doing that already, but there's a couple more things that have come in because shipping, I guess, is a little bit, you know, slow. So I want to wrap some gifts, put it under the Christmas tree, and then I'll kind of like show you guys a couple of the things that I received for my birthday or purchased for myself for my birthday. So yeah, we gotta do that. So one of the things that I ended up buying myself for my birthday was this pajama set from Victoria's Secret. I went to Victoria's Secret, and they've been having some good deals at Victoria's Secret, I want to say, lately. And they've been doing daily deals where they have different promos and stuff going on. So check them out if you're interested in like some loungewear or pajamas or, you know, just other deals. Like, they've had deals on bras and whatnot too. So check them out. But let me show you guys the pajamas. Because I told you guys that I wanted, like, on my Christmas/birthday wish list, I told you guys that I wanted some pajamas. So I just got these pajamas. It's like a, hopefully you can see it, it's just long sleeve, two-piece pajama set with the pants. They're really cute. I'll probably put up a picture from the Victoria's Secret website if they still have it up, but they're really soft, really nice. And I got these in a size medium. Hopefully that shows. But yeah, these really cute. Better later. I'm not wasting y'all's time. All right, and let me unbox a couple things. So I posted this on my Instagram stories. If you're not following me, I'll put a link below in the description box. But I don't know, y'all. I'm not good with Instagram though, y'all. Honestly, like, I don't know what to be posting on there sometimes. Like, it's a struggle. I'm kind of like antisocial, so it's kind of like, why are you doing social media? Yeah, I'm still trying to figure out what I want to do with my Instagram account, but if you want to follow me, the link will be below. Am I doing this right? But like I was saying, I posted this on my Instagram stories. I purchased some skincare products from Peach and Lily. They have like a Black Friday Cyber Monday sale, but usually they have like a sample sale that they would do at the beginning of December. And the sample sale prices were usually better than the Black Friday Cyber Monday prices, but all they did was recycle the sample sale to match what they had for Black Friday and Cyber Monday this year. I don't know why, but if that's going to continue, then I can just buy it on Black Friday, Cyber Monday, if y'all are just going to redo the same sale. But the sample sale used to be better prices. But I showed this, I think you guys will probably see this in this video, this essence that I use from them, or that I purchased from them. So this is my favorite essence. I purchased two of these. I purchased one for my birthday, one for Christmas. So I'm just going to wrap it and put it under the tree to open then. So I can have something to open for Christmas Day, you know? So that's something else I got. And then my dad got me something for my birthday, which came in early. I'll show you guys in a second. Let me wrap this gift, finish wrapping this gift. But yeah, my dad, he pretty much asked me what I wanted, but he's not computer savvy, and what I wanted needed to be ordered, so he just sent me the money for it, and I ordered it, and that came in. But I've been telling you guys that I wanted to get like a bag strap for my Neo Noe, so I ordered from M Craft Leather. I'll put their name on the screen, but I got my bag strap, y'all. So I cannot wait to use it now. Okay. This is what the strap looks like. It clips on. Hopefully you can. It has a similar, like, I don't know if this is a lobster claw, but you can see it looks very, very similar to the Louis Vuitton one. The only difference, like the color, and of course, like Louis Vuitton isn't stamped on theirs, but it looks very, very similar. Now the leathers, you can tell the leathers are different. Like the one from the Neo Noe is a bit matte, and this one's a little bit shinier. So not the same kind of leather, but I think she did a great job on this strap. I'm excited to start using it, y'all. So I plan on using this very, very soon. And if this footage looks terrible, I'll probably insert some clips over it, but yeah. So that was from my dad. My mom, her gift hasn't come in yet. She shipped me something. There is something happened with the package. It's showing that it's like there was an issue with it. So, and there's been no updates and tracking yet. So she's supposed to be going to the post office to figure out what happened with that package. So I don't know, but I don't know what she got me, so I guess I can show you guys when it gets, like, if it gets here, I can show you guys, because I don't know if it's going to arrive. I need a pen. I got a Sephora order in. I ordered some stuff for my birthday. This just got delivered today. So in my last video, this should be my last video, I told you guys that I wanted, I got a perfume sample. And I told you guys I wanted it, so I ordered like the travel spray of the Flower Bomb Orchid. Hopefully you can see that. So I got that. It's, I don't know if it's called a travel or a purse spray. And actually, so yeah. See my other one, I have Flower Bomb Nectar as a purse spray, and I have the bigger one in my bathroom, but yeah, those are the two. Now, let me see. Y'all, these smell so freaking similar. Like, they could be the same. They could be exactly the same, at least to my nose. They smell so freaking similar. Yeah, these could be the exact same thing. Like, I just repurchased the same thing over again, but they smell so similar to me. All right. So, next, I ordered some makeup stuff I wanted for my birthday. Also, I finally got this Laura Mercier. I guess I can come up closer. I got this Laura Mercier caviar stick, eyeshadow stick in plum. And then I got the Gucci blush, y'all. I will admit, I really think this is similar to a blush I already have by MAC, just looking at the pictures. But I mainly wanted it for this cute, like, the freaking packaging. Like, this is what I wanted. Yes. And that's... I hope I'm not blinding you guys, but that's what it looks like, or that's what the blush looks like. Okay, y'all, I went to grab my MAC blush to see, are these the same? Did I just buy the same blush again? They probably gonna look the same on my skin, but I wanna do a comparison. Okay, they're not exactly the same, but very similar. This one's more reddish. This one leans a little bit like more purpley, I would say, but they're very similar. They probably will look the same on the skin too. But I'm glad to have both, but they look kind of similar. So I guess if you missed out on, this is Raisin. If you missed out on Raisin by MAC, get the Warm Berry by Gucci. And the Gucci one has a little, it looks like it has a bit of a sheen to it. And this eyeshadow stick. I probably should do a video, like, trying on. I wanted to do, like, trying on makeup, because I got some new makeup stuff also. But I should probably do a, like, a get ready with me. Oh, this is very dark. Look at that. This is the shade Plum. All right, so I'm gonna, that's what I got myself. Oh, and, did I get in? Oh, yeah. And I also got, some custom made Vans as well. I posted these on my picture of these on my Instagram too, but y'all probably already know I love me some leopard, and I've been wanting some leopard Vans for a while, so I finally got some. I need to figure out what to wear, like probably all black or something like that, or something with black in them. Yes, but yes, I got myself some custom Vans for my birthday. Came in this nice little bag. Okay, you guys, so I think that's going to be it for this video. If you're new here, please consider subscribing, and I will see you guys in my next one.